Mexico has been optimistic and has suggested that a deal could be announced midday. Now we have the president tweeting just a few moments ago saying a big deal looking good with Mexico. This after the president over the weekend said that a deal with Mexico was getting closer by the hour. So now some optimism coming from the U.S. side of the negotiating table. Mexico's economic minister this morning said that they were working on hammering out the final issue singular between the U.S. and Mexico, but relatively coy about whether, in fact, a deal was going to be happening. But we know from our reporting from a Mexican official who texted me this morning that as of earlier this morning, talks were perceived as having concluded with an announcement coming midday today. We still have questions about what the particulars of any such a deal would be, what exactly these two sides had negotiated on, say, the content requirements for cars that are produced in the NAFTA countries. That was something that was in focus. Whether there could be an immigration element to this. Immigration was on the table when trade was also discussed, when a big delegation from the U.S. went down to Mexico right after the Mexican election in early July. So we'll see exactly what gets resolved and whether any particulars are actually announced today, Carl, because legally, the U.S. can't enter into a new bilateral deal with Mexico without notifying Congress, without entering into a big procedural to-do that would take at least 180 more days. So this is expected to be just broad contours of a deal that would be a precursor for a three-party NAFTA. Canada's foreign minister saying over the weekend that she expected to rejoin talks as soon as the U.S. and Mexico worked out its own issues. That we now expect to happen at some point midday today.
Yeah, Kayla, it's David. That was actually my question about, I think, Chrystia Freeland, that foreign minister. What can we expect with Canada? I mean, how does the mechanism work? Are they going to be presented this deal and either have to say yes or no, or is it a completely separate negotiation that then you get somewhere with them and you got to come back to Mexico?
Well, Canada has held the position, David, all along that the U.S. and Mexico were farther apart on many of these hot button issues, like how to resolve disputes among the parties, what role the WTO would play, whether there needed to be a wage ceiling or a wage floor for factory workers in these countries, what the agricultural element of this looked like, because there were some anger among certain American produce companies and farmers about Mexico seemingly dumping things like oranges and other types of produce here in the U.S. So there were a lot of issues for the U.S. and Mexico to work out, and Canada always held that, you know, once you guys close those gaps, then bring us back in and see where we can figure out a deal. There are still some very serious issues between the U.S. And Canada, specifically on the dairy front, but it is expected to be a shorter to-do list. But whether that's a short enough to-do list to finish by the end of this week, that's still the open question here.